So today we're looking at this 2000 SVT Cobra R. Probably one of the coolest Mustangs ever produced. And when this thing came out, this was the fastest factory Mustang ever built. This car right here is brand new. Just over 1,400 miles on this car. A collector bought it new, and this thing has been in the wrapper ever since. I'm just gonna kill the battery here. You open the hood, and the first thing you notice is you don't have any springs helping you. This thing is a track car. Their MO when they built this thing was to make it as lightweight as possible. While we're under here, I mean, first of all, just look at how clean this engine bay is. The thing is brand new. But, I mean, secondly, look at the power plant on this bad boy. Big Cobra R, V8, 5.4 liter, naturally aspirated, dual overhead cams, making 385 horsepower, 385 foot-pounds of torque. I mean, this thing is a whole ton of fun. Once you've spent 10 seconds with this car, or even just looking at it from a distance, you can see that this thing is not just a typical Mustang with a couple performance options. This is a factory-built track car, if not race car. Right away off the hop, you see the big power dome hood to accompany the big 5.4 liter. And I think what really makes this thing look so tough is the front fascia. That's gotta give this thing just so much downforce and so much front grip going around the racetrack. But equally as striking, the big rear spoiler on this thing. This has to be the most aggressive aero package, short of the Daytona Coupe, that Ford's ever come out with. One of my favorite parts about this car is that it's got the side exhaust, the Borla side exhaust with the tipped exhaust there. And then as we're down here, you can look right through this super lightweight five-spoke wheel. You can see the Brembo brakes. And frankly, what makes a track car so good when you're gonna build one of these things? Yeah, it's gotta be able to get up and go, but this is not a drag car. This is a road course car. It's gotta be able to stop well in every corner. Just at a glance looking through here, you can tell they weren't playing around when they built this thing. Big 800 iBox springs in here. Gas charged Bilstein shocks. You can see right here, of course, the yellow. You look back here, probably the best safety feature on this car is they didn't go with the gas tank. They went straight up right out of the gate with the fuel safe. So you come up to the front here, big 13-inch rotors, four piston Brembo aluminum calipers, and you see how the front brakes are vented. You come to the nose here, you can see where they're picking up the air and scooping it straight to the front brakes, trying to get those things cool. I mean, the car did over 170 miles an hour. From 60 to zero, it stopped in 110 feet. That's pretty darn good braking performance. So they wrap these five-spoke aluminum 18-inch wheels in BF Goodrich G-Force tires. They actually designed this compound specifically for the Cobra R. For the year 2000, this was almost the perfect no-nonsense track car. The only bone I have to pick with the design is giving it ABS brakes. If it didn't have that, it would be perfectly raw. Now the interior could probably possibly not be more stripped down, and frankly, I love it. I mean, this thing doesn't even have AC. It's got the radio delete. So probably the fanciest part of this car are these Recaro seats. Great little track seats. I mean, they move back and forth and they're not quite as sturdy as I'd like for a track car, but what are you gonna do? It's not a full-on race car. And this is great. You can check your blood pressure and adjust your lumbar at the same time. So we've got the B&M shifter here controlling the T56 Tremec 6-speed tranny. This is the first Mustang ever to be produced with the 6-speed here. So you notice here, obviously, the radio delete. The MO on this thing was to make it as lightweight as possible. They didn't have sound deadening. They didn't have insulation in the car. They deleted the radio. They also deleted the rear seats. And really, the only other fancy item on the interior is the SVT on the floor mats. Pretty tough looking car from the driver's seat. You see the big bulge in the hood. You look in your rear view mirror, you can see the big rear spoiler. This thing went down the drag strip pretty quick at a 12.9 at 110 miles an hour. That's nothing to sneeze at. So pretty standard as far as telemetry goes. You've got your water temperature, you've got your oil temperature, and they just have a hot and a cold. They've got no numbers in between. So I guess they were trying to save weight there as well. So as far as collectability goes, there were only 300 of these things produced. As far as I'm concerned, if you're a Mustang collector, this thing is mandatory to have in your collection. I think you could have your cake and eat it too. You could buy this car as a collectible with some future upside. And if you got one that was a little bit more mild up, you could take it to the racetrack on weekends. With 300 of these things produced, frankly, there aren't many other Ford products that are so low in production numbers. I mean, yeah, you could look at the original GT40, sure, but something like this for under 100 grand and only 300 produced, that's tough to beat. Now, I know it wasn't a Cobra R, but the first car that I ever took to the racetrack was one of those orange Mustangs, same year that they had at Bondurant. I lapped that thing all day long and had the best time. It was so well balanced, so much fun. So I could imagine how much better this thing is with a lot more aero, a lot more brakes, better suspension. This thing is a real force to be reckoned with on the racetrack. Got the factory binder here. Now the interesting thing with this car is typically we'd look through the paperwork and I'd show you guys what options this car has, but this car, they all came the same. They all came red. There were no options you could get. As that car sits, that's how all 300 were built. So we look here right off the bat, little tag. This car's number 96 of 300. So this is an interesting sheet right here. It's got the list of all the partners in performance, all the aftermarket companies that participated in the 2000 Cobra R project. So then you can go down your list here. B&M Shifter, BF Goodrich, Bilstein, Borla Exhaust, Brembo Brakes, so on and so forth. So there's some great photos in here of these things being built. Got the engine building process here in the shop. And seeing the engine out of the car, I mean, this thing looks the part of a proper race engine. Looking down the assembly line here, all the cars coming down the line in the same color, red. So we got in here, extra key fob still in the wrapper, media CD from new. So in the front of the binder here, you've got the Ford SVT certificate. It's got the VIN number. This car is a limited edition, number 96 of 300. That's pretty much all you could get for this thing, and this car being brand new with the binder, it's got everything that it came with. So now we've got to ask ourselves, do you need a car like this? Well, there's no back seat, there's no air conditioning, there's no radio, there's no sound deadening, there's no insulation. No, you don't need a Cobra R. But do you want a car like this? For under 100 grand, one of the toughest looking Mustangs ever built? Yeah, you want an SVT Cobra R.